Welcome to a HyperLynx DRC training video, where today we will be focusing on one DRC in particular, and that DRC is differential pair phase matching rule. By clicking on the rule and expanding the spreadsheet, we can look at the overview of the purpose of this rule, and it's a little in depth, so bear with me here. The purpose is from the driver to the receiver. Two nets of a differential pair shall be statically phase matched, meaning that the skew of the entire length should not exceed the total max skew. And number two, dynamically phase matched. They cannot be out of phase by the phase max skew for a running length of equal to or greater than the max running length. Scrolling down, we can see the parameters here being the total max skew and the phase max skew and the max running length that we just mentioned, and it explains what they are and shows a picture depicting where they are in the design. Here in the parameters window, we can set our driving component. Here I've set it as component U21 and the receiving component being J13 for this design. These parameters will be changed and edited depending on your own PCB. So I've actually targeted this differential pair phase matching on a selected object list of PCIe differential pairs. There are 33 differential pairs in this PCIe diff pair object list. So with that, I want to execute the rule on this object list and see if there are any violations and then analyze them. So going to the spreadsheet and looking at the violations, I will select a violation. And here in the details window, we have the reiteration of the parameters overview setup. Red meaning the violation area, yellow being the differential pair where it's in phase, red starting where it's out of phase, and this tan color showing the max running length being exceeded. Going back to that parameters overview, it's a little bit easier to tell here from the picture of the violation with the arrows pointing out these features. You start with the pins of the driving component, in this case the driving component's U21, and you can see all along the yellow of the differential pair we're good here, and then we get to this red area, and that's where the phase max skew, the skew becomes greater than that phase max skew. You can set the parameters for your phase max skew according to your IC vendor guidelines here. So looking at the violation again, we can see on this differential pair, this PCIe differential pair, we are using U21 as a driving component, and at this point is where we have exceeded our phase max skew. And then going back to the picture, we can see where running length exceeds the max running length, and it begins here at the end and is shown in this tan color. So for this error, it starts here in this portion of the diff pair. Looking at another violation, we can see some similarities here in how the violations are depicted in the same manner, and use HyperLynx DRC to check our phase max skew and our max running length and identify all the violations in accordance to our IC vendor guidelines. Thanks for training with us today, and I hope that this was helpful.